to get to work on time.
Come on, kid.
He's living the dream.
Come on, kid.
I got the hustle. Oh, my muscles getting big and hot. I be sweating like a pig.
Got to hurry.
Got to get to work on time. I got to go pack a lunch here, working overtime after taxes. Barely make it down.
Yeah.
Got to get to work on time.
National anthem.
Got to get to work on
your feet. It is 2 minutes, now 3 minutes past the hour. The kid has a decision to make. What woman will he pick this morning?
Yeah.
Well, we know it's been a great run for the kid. I'm been no doubt about that.
Living the dream.
Living the dream. There he is, our Fat-chelor Casio Kid. Better known to some folks in the inside circles as Jesse.
You know, somebody asked me that. It's so funny because the way they said it was so funny. What's it like to be Rick or Bubba? And you know what? Today, Casio knows. He's been living the dream. You can't believe it.
I know. I can't believe
He's
it.
He's just living large and loving life and, hey, number one.
Should our quick poll be worded this? What does the website say? Who will he pick or who should he pick?
Because
let's do the opposite of whatever the website says.
I think, just in my mind, Rick, it should be who will he pick. Who will be the winner?
So who do they think I'm going to pick?
Yes.
Is that the poll?
So it's not who should he pick. It's who do you think he will pick.
I need who should I pick.
That's what you would prefer?
Casio, let me ask you this seriously. You don't have to say you haven't if it's not. Have you made your mind up? Right now, do you know who you're going to pick?
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay. Would these polls and messages, though, could they sway you?
Yes.
Sure they could, Rick.
Yes.
Well, definitely for him, should we do who should he pick then? Just for his...
Who should he pick? Who should he pick is the question.
Who should he pick? In your opinion, if you were him, who should he pick?
You're looking out for Casio's future. Who should he pick?
Yeah. Right.
You're Casio's mom. Who should he pick?
That's right.
By the way, let me comment on that. Whoever's got mamacast.com, stop that, okay?
Yep,
quit, okay? Right now.
What's your opinion on the Rick and Bubba official?
Everybody!
Quick poll.
Who should Casio kid? Let me phrase it again.
Who should
he pick?
I'll keep score.
David and Coleman, who should Casio pick here in just a few minutes?
I think you should pick Megan.
Okay. David, Kingsport, Tennessee.
Can I give a quick reason why, just a one sentence, why they want
okay,
they feel
right.
that way?
Should
okay.
I will allow one sentence answers. David in Kingsport.
Yes, I think you ought to pick Casey, the one with the C, not Megan.
Candace,
yes.
Okay, why?
Because she seems more to fit in with the family than Megan did.
Okay.
David, please, sir, I know it's Friday.
I know.
But you're getting started a little early, sir.
Yeah,
let's back it down to maybe this afternoon.
Valentine.
Van Cleve, man. Chuck
this
is standing by.
This ain't St. Patrick's Day. Come on.
Who should Casio pick?
Megan.
Why?
Because I believe she's really looking for love. I believe she's really putting it out there and putting herself in a position to to have a relationship.
Okay.
Okay.
Tanya, who should he pick?
I think he should pick Candace.
And why?
I think she's the real deal.
Okay. Mm. Rick and Bubba Show, you're on the quick poll. Who do you think he should pick in one sentence? Why?
I think he should pick Candace because she's just got such a wonderful personality and seems like a really nice girl.
Okay.
Good. I know this is helping Casio out. We're dead, Todd.
Yeah, it's dead.
Sure.
Hey, Rick and Bubba Show, who do you think he should pick? That's how I sound on the radio over the phone. Yeah, hello?
Yes. You know
what?
They couldn't make their mind up.
I know.
It was too much.
Hey, you're on the Rick and Bubba quick poll. Who do you think you should pick in one sentence? Why?
Good morning, Rick and Bubba.
Jeff
from Pinson.
Or actually, formerly of Pinson.
Yes,
yeah. Now, but you'll always be Jeff from Pinson in our heart.
Yes.
Hey, Cassio, how's everything, man?
I'm doing pretty good, Jeff. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing good. Hey, man, I think Megan is definitely the girl for you.
Now, why do you think that, Jeff?
Well, I just think they look better together. I think, you know, especially from the first show.
Jeff, thanks for your concise reason.
Jeff, we said one sentence.
You're killing me.
Am I saying too much, then?
Yes.
You're killing me.
Hi, Rick and Bubba Show. Who do you think you should pick?
I think you should take that biscuit and find Alana.
Okay, sure.
Hi, Rick and Bubba Show. Who do you think you should pick?
I think he needs to pick Brooke from The Bachelor.
This person, it is possible, may be in charge of children.
Yes.
Hi, Rick and Bubba Show. You got 30 seconds. Who do you think he should pick?
Megan.
Should be in it. Why do you think that?
From the beginning. First date. They have the chemistry. Plus, what can I say? Hot tub.
Yeah, that fired you up there, didn't it? Will you take that and get that information from me? Thank you very much. The hot tub scene, I think, really helped Megan. Hi, Rick and Bubba Show. What do you think? Quick poll.
I think he should pick Candace.
And why?
Because her dad owns a company, and there could be some financial stability there.
Oh, well.
Oh. Software company. I forgot
That's
about
right.
that. Hey. Did you ever even think about that?
No.
Huh?
I need to, though.
Hey, Rick and Bubba Show, who do you think you should pick and why?
I think you should pick Candace. I think she's more mature, and she fit in more with the family, and I don't think she hit anything up front. I think they look cute together.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Have you been keeping the last few votes?
Kind of.
Yeah.
Sort of.
Yeah.
Hey, Rick.
Yeah, I'm up, right? Am I good here?
I think so. What you got, Dave?
4-4.
What have you got?
That's what I got.
5-4. Who got
this? Well, see, that ain't that big a difference.
All right, you need one. Candace is up by one.
Okay.
Hey, Rick and Bubba.
You act like I was way off. It was one vote. Come on. I looked at breakfast here a minute ago. I got a little off track.
Who do you think you should pick and why?
More Greg Burgess.
All right, he will not be picking Greg.
Yeah.
No.
As a matter of fact, Greg is probably the furthest from that position one man could ever be.
Yes.
Hi, Rick and Bubba Show. Good morning.
Yeah, I think Casio should pick Megan because if you got a girl that is that crazy about a fat guy, you got to hold on to her.
Yeah, I knew that. There's that sentiment out there going, look. Because, see, you're not just picking for yourself, though you think you are.
The big guys love it.
You're picking for the large nation.
Sure.
Hi, Rick and Bubba Show. Good morning.
Yeah. They ought to pick Candace.
And how come?
Wisdom born of pain. I'm on my fourth wife. But I tell you what, I'm gonna grow old with this one.
Yes.
She is a wonderful lady, and I think Candace will fit the bill for him.
Okay. All right. Thank you, man. Do you know, I met a guy the other day, and I'm not making this up. I'm not going to say his name because I don't want to embarrass him. He has been married 14 times.
Oh, Rick, he did.
Stop
you
it.
You can't do that, can
14
you? Isn't there laws
times.
Against that?
And he's been married to his wife now for 20 years, which meant he got married 13 times in like 20 years.
Who? Rick Burgess. Do I know this person?
No, I don't think
we're not talking about Mark Garnett again.
No. Hey, Rick and Bubba Show. Who do you think he should pick and why?
Definitely Candace.
Uh-huh.
Or else every day he's going to wonder if Megan is cheating on him because she is a big flirt. She's a nice girl, she seems like.
No, not a cat fight. Okay.
Hey, wait a minute, Dee. I've lost count again. What do you have?
7-5, Candace.
All right. 7-5. Once again, it appears that the favorite has fallen off after a date.
Yeah.
Can anybody be the favorite going in and still be the favorite coming out?
Alana was the favorite going into the date.
First date, then Megan.
Then Megan.
Now Candace is ahead.
Hey, Rick and Bubba Show, who do you think you should pick and why?
Megan, because she's
really.
She's
good
fine.
For him.
You think she's fine, don't you, young man?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. Good. Which is a good theory.
That's a 13-year-old boy that's got to vote for you. Hey, Rick and Bubba show. Who do you think he should
pick? We may have a preview there.
Oh, he ought to pick Candace, man. Look at that bod on her.
Okay.
All right, number one.
Now the hounds are coming out. Sure. Hey, Rick and Bubba show. Who do you think you should pick and why?
I think we ought to go with Megan.
Okay. So is it tied?
I'll go to D.
Candace is up by one.
8-7,
Candace. Candace up by
one. I got 9-8, Megan. I don't know.
Hey, Rick and Bubba show, what do you say?
I think Candace, because I just believe that
Casio
and Candace go together better.
All right. Well, what you got Candace up by one vote, or two votes?
Two.
Up by two votes. Listen to the difference in that in the website. How was the question formed?
What
Willie pick or who should
it? Who will Casio pick?
Everybody thinks on the web that he will pick Megan 64% to 36%. Over 6,000 people voted.
Let me tell you this. So two days ago, Megan was 85 to 15.
Yeah, Candace has closed the gap and is ahead in the quick vote by two votes.
Hmm. Man.
I tell you, I just, wow.
Well, we'll hear from the ladies when we come back. Also,
we're going to get to hear another message?
Very special day to Maggie Elder. Maggie Elder is having her 10th special day today. Her dad is a swimming coach and takes care of Big Love, and wanted to tell her a happy birthday this morning from all of us here at the show. We'll be
you
back.
Tell he's got a few acres.
He's got some land. You want to talk to him?
Sure.
Yeah. He's got another guy, though, has an option next to him.
No, I'll pass.
Okay, we'll be back.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.
Oh, wow.
We're back 18 minutes past the hour. Starting to set the tone now.
Wow.
We're gonna you remember this one?
Hello. How are you? Have you been all right? All these lonely, 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 lonely.
As we get back, it is time laughter in the room as we get ready for the Fat-chelor. There's one biscuit left, and there's two ladies who want it today. Which one will receive the biscuit?
Who's going to get that biscuit?
I want to say hello to Amanda Mike Cruz, who works for Media Visions here, that brings you the footage you see on Turner South, having her 8th birthday today, too. So I want to wish her a happy one from her daddy and all of us here who work on the show. As we get back, we will talk to Candace now. Candace joins us. Candace, welcome to the show. You have been such a good sport. You have... You've really won the hearts of a lot of people in the Rick and Bubba audience. As a matter of fact, the latest poll from who should he pick was you on our quick poll just moments ago.
By a slice of bacon.
Yeah. Who will he pick? You have closed the gap on that also based on your last date with his family. So I think you...
Are you nervous?
Oh, yeah, I'm getting a little nervous now.
How about I'm nervous?
I am, too. And if you think you're nervous, you are to be the cable operator in Trustful, Alabama this
morning. Whoever's got to answer that phone is not going to be
happy. About that. Me and Megan were like, our grandmothers live in Trustful. What are we going to do?
We got a call that Trustful, Alabama, which if you look at our audience, is probably one of the hottest spots out there across the country. Their cable is down right now. And, buddy, they are not happy. But nothing we can do about it. So
it's kind of like living in Nashville where you can't see it anyway.
Right. And how about living in Nashville going, what, we don't have Turner South in Nashville? So parts of Nashville, I know you do, but the ones that do not, can you imagine Turner South not on in Nashville?
That doesn't even make sense.
But anyway, so we're hoping to get all that resolved this year as we expand. But the people who can see you and hear you right now, what are your thoughts sitting here right now today? You feel like you've... presented yourself as best you can and just see what happens?
Yeah, I think I've done all I can do. You know, I went out there and the first time, you know, I was a little shy, but I opened up toward the end and I just gave him me and what he does with it, you know, that's him. Hope he doesn't make a mistake, you know, and not pick me, because that would be a mistake.
Well, there it is.
There it is. Let me ask you this.
I'm just going to be honest with you.
When you first saw Jesse and now after going out with him and apparently having some connection, What is different from what you expected?
Well, when I came into this, I wasn't thinking, you know, I was like, well, this will be fun. I wasn't thinking I'd, like, get involved, you know. And then after the first date, I was
emotionally?
Like... Emotionally? Yeah, I didn't think I'd get involved.
Right.
Didn't think I would. So, you know, as it went on a little bit more, I started to get, you know, more and more. And he just kind of, you know, grew on me a little bit. So.
He will. Casio will grow.
That's what we call a case of the kid.
Yep.
Yeah, and I'd like to also make something clear. People talk about moving my mic around a lot. You know, I'm going to tell you why. One shot, it needs to be here.
Yeah.
Another shot, it needs to be here.
Right.
So I have to move it based on what shot it is. I'm sorry. I do my best. Headsets.
Yeah.
I looked up mine now to see if I've got it set up for this shot, but I don't have it set up for that shot or this shot. It's hard for me not to. That's why I move it around a lot. And I've got Tourette's.
But other than that, you're good.
Yeah.
Candace, look, and we got to know this because this came to light yesterday. Not that this would be part of the decision process, but just because me and Rick are hens. Like,
right.
Is your dad rich? I mean, what is
because
that?
There's a rumor out there that he is.
Because his software people have started piling in the email.
Yeah.
Hey, tell Casio he doesn't know what he's missing.
My folks at Bankware are very supportive of me, but that's actually my stepdad. I live with him and my mom. And,
he does very well.
Yeah,
well,
it's
good
a
for
basic
him.
Software company. I mean, we're not, like, loaded.
It's America. That's
right.
A great thing.
They're just wanting to know, is there a chance he might buy Casio some new DJ equipment?
There's a big joke. People at the office like to, call me, like, well, she's the boss's daughter.
They
kind of
sent
that in as a joke, but, yeah.
That's good.
Well, Jesse, he works on a computer every day, doesn't he? If you count solitaire.
Yeah.
I'm joking, Mama Cass. That was a good one, Speedy. Thanks.
Yeah. Has this been more nerve-wracking and a lot tougher than you thought it would be?
Yeah, well, at first it wasn't, but it's gotten to that point. My mom's about to drive me crazy.
Really?
She's just, oh, my goodness.
Has it helped your self-confidence? Or
yes, a lot.
Have you been getting the emails? I mean, we don't have any way to officially forward them to you. I haven't been, but...
No, but I've been hearing you talk about them.
Do you want all of them? I don't know which intern will want to stay here all weekend and clean them off the hard drive.
Yeah, let me tell you.
All three of you. I think there's a perception that this is good, this is not, but I'm telling you, there's different tastes for different folks, and if you fit the mold, then, hey, there's hounds,
Well, what we're saying is...
And I'm glad some girls like fat guys,
Me too.
Yeah. Like my wife.
I think this may be the year of the biggin.
Yeah, I know.
So we're kind of excited about that. But what we're saying is no matter what happens to any of you, as Alana's already found out, there are people willing to go out with y'all if you don't get picked. So
now that people know you're out there.
Yeah, but
you're a TV star.
I was talking to Alana, called me the other day, and she was telling me, she was like, I'm going to miss it, but I'm excited to go into California and, try to see what I can do now that I got more confidence. I was like, well, go, girl.
Well, yeah, y'all have done well. I don't think any of you have anything to be embarrassed about, and I don't think you cast yourself in a bad light in any way. And he's got, there's no way he can lose. If he picks any of you three, he's going to do well.
Oh, yeah, Megan's a great girl, too. She really
Have y'all been in a cat fight at all?
No.
Does it bother you? Because you didn't expect to have any feelings whatsoever. Once you went out twice with the kid, did it bother you to see him kissing on Megan?
Yeah, it did bother me a little bit, but it was part of the thing, so I had to.
That's part of having a case of the kid.
That's right. Yeah, it is. Speedy.
We got an interesting email about a pack that y'all made.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
Did y'all make a pack together?
Oh my
Candace?
God. Oh my
Candace?
Gosh. Oh my gosh.
This is a pack free zone.
If you did.
We didn't make a pack. We talked about the hot tub thing not doing it. But I don't think a pack was ever made.
Y'all said,
I couldn't do it because I had just had surgery.
Right. You made that clear.
And so she said, well, I don't really want to do it. And she said, well, why don't we just not do it since you can't do it? And I said, okay. But there was not
Now, when did y'all talk?
Of course, Megan didn't stick to it. But anyway, it's okay.
When did y'all talk? And how did y'all secretly get numbers from each other or something?
Yeah, we talked about it at breakfast the other morning. And, I don't know how anybody was known.
Weren't supposed to make contact, but that's okay. Dave's going to have a conversation with you about that.
Y'all back to penalty points.
That's right. Yeah. In other words, let's put it this way. If you made a pact, it wasn't a very good one.
Yeah. Because you got burnt.
Yeah. Kinda, now you know how Bubba felt yesterday when he went to close. But, we come back.
Please just keep referring back to that all,
sure, that's sure. all day.
Did you step back on any lane?
We come back. We will talk with Megan and play their final messages to Casio, and then he's got a decision, Mike.
Good luck to you, girl.
Thank you.
Thank you, and it's been a pleasure to get to know you. We'll be right back.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.
Y'all, I'm telling y'all, every time...
Yeah.
Megan's
I'm
here.
Nervous.
I mean, you're visibly nervous.
You're visibly nervous.
She's about to pass out. I tried to tell her it's okay.
It's all right, Megan.
Look, Speedy, ease up. Don't be casting your spell over there. I'm hugging on everybody. Back up.
You're going to get mailed
don't
again.
Look. Yeah, don't get caught. You're don't let Megan get caught up in that. What you know?
Matter of fact, won't you put
in
that,
your ripple effect.
That,
yeah.
that big, huge gift bag between you and Megan.
Yeah.
So that, it can't happen.
We just, look. It's not you.
It's
just,
not you. It's
you
not
just
you.
Ooze.
It is not you.
You just ooze, man. You can't help it.
Do y'all
you
like, help y'all like whisper to each other? Watch what we're going to do to Speedy.
No. That's usually
Megan,
D.
Where are they even getting this from?
I don't know.
All I've done is been polite to you.
Right.
I just try to make sure
it's
that...
It's not your fault.
All I try to do is make sure that they
Speedy, this segment's about Megan.
Stand behind
this
gift bag where she just...
I'm going to start being so mean to everybody.
Because she's in a receptive mode now. She's looking for
love. She's vulnerable.
She's looking for love. And just the mere presence of you can cause...
And you got Greenwood over here? I mean, good gosh.
I mean,
you're liable to get, like, radio interference in here. There's so many signals bouncing around.
Everywhere she looks, it's a good-looking man. They'll give her a break.
I'm dying.
You
want to
know what it is? They didn't close yesterday, so they're, like, they're hurt.
Right.
It's like,
we're injured.
Like
we're the wounded dog. We're injured.
Yeah.
But really, it's not your fault. You've done nothing inappropriate.
Okay.
Megan, welcome
that.
To the show. This segment's about you when we get Speedy to hush. First off, thank you for being here. You and Candace are so sweet to be a part of this and live your life in front of the camera for a little while.
Has that been hard?
Yeah. Especially the kissing scenes and stuff, you know. Because,
yeah.
I mean, and I really like him, and it's hard. And especially when, last night, like in the hot tub scene, his family was standing over there, like his whole family. And you can't see them. And so I'm thinking, okay.
Well, we can see Bobby Bowden sitting in there with you.
And I'm thinking his mom's there, and I'm probably, I mean, maybe I'll be coming back, and, you know, she's going to remember this, and it's on tape, you
right,
know?
Sure.
And he's, you know, and he's getting in the groove, and he's wanting to kiss.
He did close in. It didn't bother him.
And I was just getting so nervous because I just had that in my head the whole time.
I know, but we were just so proud of the kid.
Yeah, Megan, I got to ask you this.
He was eager, wasn't he?
As we look back at everything that has happened, you came out on the first date, you were aggressive.
Yeah.
Okay. Alana was kind of the favorite going in, and then after the first date, you were the favorite.
Mm-hmm.
And then you seemed like you pulled back a little bit on the trip to Mama Cassis. Now, did you do that on purpose, or did it just come across that way?
Yeah, did somebody
did you make
you,
a plan, hey, I'm out there too far, I need to pull back
yeah,
a little bit?
Yeah, did somebody say, you know, I saw your last date, and I'm a friend of yours, and I love you. You might have been a little too aggressive. Did you have that feeling? Because really, that's what worked for you, though.
Some people were saying stuff to me, but
they got in your head, didn't they?
But basically, it was just, I wanted to know if it was for real. He knew, after the first date, that I liked him. He knew that I had feelings for him.
That was obvious.
And, you know, and he knew that that's what I wanted, that I wanted him, and I wanted to be in a relationship with him. So I just, and I knew he was probably kissing Candace, and I just wanted, okay.
Well, you've got a pretty grill, and people need to be able to see.
Sure. Okay.
Yeah. Right.
So I felt bad, like.
Well, she does have good teeth.
Yeah, she got a good grill.
Sure.
Hey, what are you doing?
You're losing my train of thought.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Hey, y'all pull it back. Come
sorry about that.
Doing.
Sorry about that. Look, but see, I've got a barricade. I worked out a little bit yesterday. Somebody will get me. Okay. All right, go ahead.
But anyway.
I'll draw it over here. Yeah.
I was trying to wait, you know, because I thought, you know, if he really likes me, I'll get a kiss. And kisses a lot of them after all this is over. So.
Right. And does it bother you watching him kiss like Candace?
A little bit.
So, did you see him open mouth kiss?
Mm-hmm.
So, Ricky had to bring it
well,
up.
I'm,
right there.
Well, that's why we're. I mean, I'm sorry. I mean, I'm a commentator.
But I mean, he's loving this, though. I know that.
Well, sure
I mean,
he is. Sure he is.
And I know that, you know, Speedy's probably over there. Do it, do it, do it, you know. So, I mean.
So, is that what it's like?
I know what's going on, you know.
Well,
so.
in all honesty, if I can just, you know, we all do know one thing. Mm-hmm. This, from the very beginning, is a game, hoping there will be love. But it also is a radio show and a TV show. And Speedy, as producer, and Don Juan as assistant producer, their job was to bring back something entertaining as well. So y'all were kind of caught in the middle of that, trying to be yourselves, but at the same time, you know, there were certain things that you know the audience wanted to see, and were, you know, they wanted to know whether y'all were compatible or not.
Yeah, I mean, like the other night, I mean, I would have been happy sitting there looking at his pictures with his mom for 3 hours, but I know everybody wanted to see that hot tub thing. So, you know, I mean, you know.
And don't forget, too, while we're doing this, we're spinning off The Bachelor.
Yes.
And that was the big thing. Every time Aaron opened his mouth, it was, yeah, hey, let's go to the hot tub.
Sure.
You know, and so we got, you know, the Bama room. Come on, we played off that. I mean,
yeah.
So don't anybody lose sight of why we started.
Right. Well, Megan, do you look at The Bachelorette different now? Do you wonder how things really are compared to what we've seen on TV?
Yeah, do you watch that show different?
Do you have a different feel for what's going on?
Yeah, but I mean, I think some people are genuine, though. I mean, you know.
Well, there's no doubt about that. I mean, there's both of you have developed a rapport with him that you probably didn't know whether that was going to happen or not. You probably came here, said, I'm going to play the game and see what happens. And I know that, I'm not trying to speak for Candace, based on our talk with her and based on our talk with you, y'all both genuinely would like to be picked today.
Yeah, I mean, I...
Now, there's some people think if you get picked, you'll dump Casio in 2 weeks.
I know.
Can you address that?
I like him. I haven't felt the way I feel about him, about somebody, in a long time. And he just... I clicked with him on the first date, and I've tried to show him that... how I really feel this whole time, and if he doesn't know that by now, then I don't know what else I can do. I mean,
you feel like you've made yourself known, and now he has to decide.
Yeah.
I've got some antibiotics. I've been sick. Do you need it for a case of the kid?
I might.
Okay. Well, let's see the final messages from each one. Thank you very much, Megan, right, and good luck to you, okay?
Hey, well, look, I wanted to know, because it really didn't have anything to do with his decision, but did you have an old boyfriend named, Tub that called yesterday?
I listened.
Who was Tub?
I was thinking, I was like, who the heck is that? I mean... I don't know. I've never...
If you have a boyfriend that's nicknamed as Tub, you probably will remember it.
You would remember that.
Yeah, you might forget a Jason along the way, but not a Tub.
Listen, I've turned a lot of people down in my time, so, I mean, there's probably a lot of guys that are pissed off.
Well,
so to speak.
I'm sorry, right. I'm sorry, but...
Well, you know what it's like to be Speedy. Sure. But he, too, was able to settle down and find the woman of his dreams. And,
right.
And you can find the man of your dreams. And maybe it's the kid.
Have you been kind of a player yet?
No.
Is it, too?
I'm really picky.
How did you feel about everybody critiquing every single move? Isn't that a little much?
Yeah. And I didn't know how it would feel seeing myself on TV actually kissing somebody. And I knew what I was feeling when it happened. And I was just like, you know, and I don't know if I like sharing that intimacy with everybody.
Well, no. Did you look the way you thought you looked? Because I had a feeling that in my mind, I am a romantic devil kissing my wife.
Sure.
And
I'm Rhett Butler.
Yeah. And I am looking good. I got a bad feeling if it was on camera, I might go, oh my gosh, what's that face about?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of things
that
are on camera.
I overanalyzed it too. I mean, I went back and looked at him going, was that a good look he made after he kissed me? Or was that, you know.
Where he looked like he'd lost his mind?
Let me tell you, that was a good look.
Yeah, that was a good look.
Because I looked at that over and over, and I was like, please let it be a good look.
Well, we'll come back. You know. The decision is around the corner.
It was that look like he couldn't breathe.
Yeah, we've all had that. That's a good look. That's good.
Okay.
We'll come back. We will hear their final messages, and then Casio Kid will have one biscuit and two women.
Mm.
Then followed by that, at the top of the next hour, Trista, the Bachelorette, will be here, who has been pursued and is the pursuer. She knows both sides. We'll be back. Unbelievable.
And, buddy, it was really blocked.
Hey, folks. Again, how can that happen every time?
Do we need to put a red light up there?
All right, we're back. 15 minutes to the top. Casio's back. The ladies have been put in our office.
They're not in our office, are they?
No, they can hear it in the office.
No, they're in the break room.
They're in the break room. Okay. What we're going
to say, there's no room in there.
What we're going to do now is we're going to play back Casio searching yesterday for the perfect gift to give to whoever he picks today from Jewelers 3. We went over there, Speedy and he were doing a remote yesterday, he and Speedy, and they picked that. Also, Peggy's Hallmark's got a beautiful gift basket for the one that is picked. Spa Moshe, I think, has got some kind of $500 gift certificate they're going to give for her to be spoiled after she is picked to get ready for, I guess, y'all's first date as a couple.
What do I get?
You get the lady. I mean, you get the date out of your league for a little bit.
Okay, good boy.
See what you can do with it.
Okay,
so...
And I've got one prepaid land closing I'll throw in, because it doesn't look like I'm going to get to use it.
So we're going to now play Casio, his search yesterday for the gift for his special lady today. And we'll join that. All right. right, walking up to the jewelry store.
Flagship station logo there.
Yeah. There you go, Annie. There he is.
Hey, man. Hey, man. How you doing, man? Got a few pieces here I want to show you.
It's John.
Check them out. What do we got for them? That's about a 1-carat baguette heart piece.
All right.
This is a 1.5-carat baguette and princess cut heart piece.
Okay.
And this is about a 1-carat pavé set heart piece.
And they're all beautiful.
Baguettes.
So what do you like? What do you think about them all?
Well, each piece is nice. I mean, you won't go wrong with any of them.
Right.
It's personal preference. These two are in yellow gold. This one's in white gold.
Man. Casio,
that's
checking
them out. That's princess cut, is that what you said?
That's princess cut and baguette. That's a hoss there.
That is a big necklace. Do I want a big necklace? I like the looks of this one right here. What'd you say this was?
That's a pavé set 1-carat piece.
Pavé set.
That's too hard to say, Casio.
Yeah, pavé, you'll never
say
that.
Say princess, that's easier.
Oh.
See, it goes through on the side. And it hangs sideways.
Could you spell that?
Wow.
No.
I had a puppy dive at one time.
You want to take one of them out of the mids now? Kind of like on the Fat-chelor?
Don't have to cut one? I'm tired of cutting things. This is too much cutting.
Cut one now, and then we'll look at the other two.
So it continues.
All right. I like this one and this one, so we'll have to cut this one. Man, they're both beautiful. I just don't know. This could be tougher than picking a girl. I'm just kidding.
I'll tell you. Look at you.
They're both great pieces. You can't go wrong with either one of them.
I think.
Come on, Casio. It's just a 2-hour trip.
This is a good half here. Where this one's just a carrot.
I mean, it's just a carrot. Like, that's nothing impressive. You know what, John? I like this one. This is going to be the one right here.
Which one you go? Got you all ready, man.
Oh, I appreciate it, man. You guys have been great here.
Thank you. Good luck with your decision.
You went with Parvo.
Thank you. We'll see you guys later.
We love the show.
It's a good choice. Look at him. Got his choice like he likes it. Well, there it is.
Oh, yeah.
So you picked it out.
All right, let's see the messages.
Hear the message now. I've got a special song that we're going to play. This is a special song. I don't have Gary's last name.
I'm just excited.
You okay?
But a guy named Gary threw a young lady named Patty at Mother's Day out, gave me this CD. It was written especially for the Factory Day. This is the song he wrote to ask his wife, Stephanie, to marry him.
Have you screened this?
I have screened it, and it's perfect for what we're doing.
And we're going to play.
Except for the last verse when he's actually asked her to marry him, we'll leave that part out. But everything up to that is perfect.
Okay. Well, look, you never know with a kid. He can surprise
you. So we'll look at D. That's my bad. I had it on my desk the whole time. I'm so sorry. All right, here I just sent D on an adventure for no reason.
Yeah.
All right, here are their final messages. This is a song that Gary, his last name is not on anything, but it is a guy named Gary. So here it is. Very good song.
Garry.
Hey, Casio, it's Candace. I just wanted to say thank you so much for letting me have this opportunity to come meet you. You are such a wonderful guy. I would love to get the biscuit, like to see, you know, where this relationship could go. And I just hope you don't make a mistake that both of us will regret, because I think I really deserve the biscuit. And so please stick me.
Hey, Jesse, I just want to say it was wonderful getting to know you.
This is Megan.
And I really want to keep dating you. And I love your family. And I really felt for you on that first day. And I swear to God, my feelings are genuine. I haven't met somebody like you in a really long time. And I hope we can still keep dating. And my stomach's been in knots for about a week. So it made me feel better if you, you know, chose me just so we could keep dating. And I really like you.
Has the dream turned into a nightmare now for Casio?
There's a glory in the way that brought us here.
That didn't help, guys.
What about the song, too? I know you're the one for me. What brought us here?
I've never held such a beauty.
That's true.
Well, the way you laugh.
Yeah, have some candy.
The way
that'll
you
help. Chocolate always helps you out.
Casio was pondering. Has all this helped or made it even harder?
The way I feel since the
harder. I bet he had his mind made up. Now he's not. He's gray again.
Well, he's only got about 8 minutes to decide what he wants to do.
I do want to get rid of the chocolate. I'm not a big fan of it.
I know you're the one for me. I know I'll never be the same. I know there's a glory in my way that brought us here.
Casio, I'm going to give you a little more time. I don't want you to make this decision when we have to go to a hard break. Nope.
Yes.
Because I would have to interrupt maybe while you're thinking.
Yeah.
I don't want you to be sitting there going, I got to do this. Oh, my gosh, I got a minute and a half.
Yeah.
So we're going to do it at the top of the hour. Also, this will be interesting, too. It is possible that Trista from The Bachelorette will be here to see you make this decision.
Standing right here beside you to put her hand on your shoulder and hopefully not distract you, but help you make a good decision.
Right. Be all according to what outfit she wears.
Sure.
Right.
Sure.
Right. Remember. Did you see? How about this?
Here's a flashback for you. Somebody had asked me how he got the name Casio Kid. It started with Jesse Mitchell, 14-year-old, sending us a tape of him doing a rap song.
Yes.
And it has evolved into today. He is the Fat-chelor, possibly looking for his soulmate.
There's no way to get a split screen of both ladies in a frozen picture for him to look at side by side.
You're killing me.
Well, I don't think there is a way. Just tell me no if there's not, Bobby.
Please tell us no.
It's hard for me to look at you serious now, Bobby Bounds, since I've seen you shirtless in a hot tub.
And but, we've had email with women who think you're hot. But anyway.
Right, sure. Yeah.
I got a lot of emails saying I should pick Bobby, but that's fine.
That's good.
That's Bobby Bowden, is this your last day with us today, Bob?
No,
no, you'll be in this one. Okay.
26.
Oh,
the
26.
Really about to cry then.
Fat-chelor.
Look at that face.
Decision time.
Forever's all I can offer.
Wow. I'm sorry.
Will you take my hand? Together we build.
How about I want to cry and I don't have to pick?
Why do I want to cry? Why do I get that feeling?
This guy played the song to ask his wife to marry him.
Will you be my whole life?
He was a lock. Man.
Oh, sure. But you got to be able to sing good to pull this off.
Sure.
Oh,
will you be my wife?
That's romantic, but I don't think you should ever not stand up in a restaurant and screaming, will you marry me? I think that's also very romantic.
Thank you, Gary and Stephanie, for us having your song for that special moment for Casio. And we wish you many happy years together. Will we have many happy years together for Casio Kid and his new love? We will find out who it is when we come back. Decision time. One biscuit, two ladies, and Trista from The Bachelorette will be here next hour as well.
Rick and Bubba, Rick. Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.
They all up in the house.
We're back and it's top of the hour.
I'm in love.
Who will it be?
With the other woman.
Who will it be?
You know, I love this song, and we use it for, you know, the Bachelor, Bachelorette, Fat-chelorette. But I'm going to tell you, if you're in high school and you got a girlfriend and you're, like, humming it in the halls, you'll have questions. I'll tell you that.
Yeah, you need to be careful. Casio, it's time. You will now have to take, and we didn't have a controversy in the break. Blair and Karen saw the necklace the Casio has picked out. She came in and tried to eat the biscuit and say, pick me. Karen.
I'm upset that I didn't choose Karen, the Bachelor, Fat-chelorette.
Go back
Karen,
out in the hall,
don't stand
honey.
In
don't
the
look.
Way.
I know this.
The diamonds.
Is
Karen.
Is Casio better looking with that necklace?
Casio is hot with those diamonds in his hand.
No, it's not Karen.
Now, when he takes the diamonds away, then, you know.
Well, easy.
It's back to Casio. But.
Okay.
Well, there it is.
Karen,
you cannot win this
Karen,
contest.
This is Casio's moment in the girl's place.
Right. And Peaches.
Bless her heart, she's just
Peaches,
green.
Peaches, where
with
is the necklace? Yeah. Where'd you put it? Find it and bring it in here. You're going on a missionary trip. Come on.
Am I hot, Peaches?
All right.
Did y'all lose the necklace?
No, we got it.
Is the biscuit here? Oh, yeah, there it is.
The biscuit's there. Well, here it is. And here they come. Wow, I'm a nervous wreck.
I am, too. I can't look.
How this is going to go.
It's real.
And there's the biscuit in a heart-shaped box for them to be presented. Casio, you will stand up. You will face these two ladies. And you will ask one of them, will they accept this biscuit? And at that moment, the other will know that they were not picked. And then, of course, the
is
other...
Trista here yet, by the way?
Trista from The Bachelorette, if she's not here,
well,
she's
hearing
it.
I just thought it'd be
it.
Funny if she's standing here next to Casio to help him out.
Well, we'll get her in here momentarily. Well,
I know they are nervous.
Well,
because I'm nervous.
Well, I'll lose my cool points if I lose my breakfast right here.
Yeah.
A little nervous.
Are you nervous?
Yes.
Casio, let me just be clear. Do not throw up. Okay? That is one rule that I will not allow, because if you do, I will. Okay?
I don't think anybody will accept the biscuit after that.
No.
All right. I'm going to stop the music.
Oh, my gosh. It's real.
And now it's time. Casio, let's get this thing underway. We've waited long enough. They've waited long enough. Just stand up, address them, and ask one of them to accept the biscuit.
Okay, let me preface this by saying you're both wonderful women, okay? And I had a great time with both of you. And my family genuinely loved both of you.
Oh, my gosh.
This really has been a tough choice. And I wish I would have met either one of you outside of the contest to, maybe go on without the contest, without the cameras and everything. Maybe it would have been a little different. But the sad part is I got to cut one of you today, and you'll probably hate me, but I really do. I apologize for cutting whoever I do, and hopefully we can still chat afterwards. But right now I got to cut one of you. Do I got to cut one of them?
Yes.
Yeah, we're not in Utah. Go ahead.
Yeah. What happens beyond this? Now, if you end up breaking up with one, you could always go back and date the other. But as of today, one will be selected for a try at this, and one will not. Wow, I hate to put it that way.
Megan, will you accept my biscuit?
There it is.
Thank you.
Oh, my gosh. Should we take them out and spend a moment?
I'm nervous.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm about to pass out.
Okay.
Oh, my gosh. This is a horrible.
Free.
We
got to get the...
Oh, my gosh.
I need to open this up.
She's opening up the necklace. Candace has to watch it.
Mm.
Oh, my gosh. Mm.
Appreciate that, Rick.
Well, I'm
good.
Well, I don't.
Did we say our goodbyes first? Is it?
Really? I mean, he tore into that necklace so fast.
Yeah, I know.
He heard what Karen said, and he wants to get it up.
If you could. Look, like I'm hot with the necklace.
Yeah, I noticed
somebody fries Karen off the back of the door.
If that
Candace
door
couldn't get out yet.
If that door won't open, it could be Karen standing in front of it. So,
okay, here we go.
Turn around,
look at me.
He's taking the necklace out. For those of you listening that cannot see this, all this will be documented on the website. We will have it up. For those of you who don't get Turner South, and there is the necklace going on.
I'm so nervous I couldn't snap it.
There it is. Why don't y'all step outside, talk a few minutes. We'll bring both of you back, and we'll speak with Candace before.
Okay.
Okay, there you go. I made that call on my own. Do you think that's the right thing,
Rick,
to do?
I'm with you.
That was
out,
me
man.
Flying there. I didn't go with producers or anything.
Good.
I just jumped
you're
out
good.
There. Is that bad? You know, I'm lost without producers now. I used to do a show myself. Now I can't do it anymore.
I feel like I got
to. Right, come here, Candace. Come here. We got to. Come here.
I hope you can breathe better than I can.
I hate this contest. It's just not.
I don't know. It's evil.
Rick, give that to her, please. Hey, okay, this give is, it to Rick.
This is...
Somebody sent you a basket, Rick?
Yeah, they said.
Couldn't it be for Candace?
It really should, and I'm going to let her have it.
Yeah, okay.
This is... do we know... Is this, do we know who this
give
is from?
Give it to her, Rick.
I know. How are you feeling right now, girlfriend?
I'm a little disappointed.
Well, I know. Here. I know. Did you...
How about a nice Rick and Bubba love pack?
Yeah, we'll send you some Rick
nice
and Bubba
t-shirt
stuff, too. I would send you bobbleheads, but that's another issue of somebody stepping out and not being able to deliver. But, we've only got about 200 of them, so we need more than 20. But let me just say, some of y'all, you will eventually get them, I promise you.
Right.
But
next year.
Next year. Somebody begs for the job, you give it to them, and then they say, I can't handle it. But let me just say this. I would give you some bobbleheads, but I don't have any. But
not that you'd want one.
Not you'd want one yet, but we will. This is horrible. We all feel terribly uncomfortable right now, but you knew he was going to have to pick. It's just the way the contest worked.
Mm-hmm.
Do you wish you'd never gotten the contest right now?
No, I don't wish I never did it. But, I knew this might happen, so...
How about this? You the girl.
You did. You really made the audience fell in love with you, but they fell in love with all of you, certain parts of the audience and all that. Everybody had their favorites, but you come away from this being shed in a very positive light on the show, TV and radio. People love you.
Well, I mean, you know, I'm upset, but, you know, Megan's a great girl, too, so he could have won
either
way.
Did y'all become friends and all that?
Yeah.
This is the point where you should tell everybody that it's good he didn't pick you because you're shipping off to Kuwait.
Yeah, that's how Alana got out of this.
I wish I did have something like that, you know, so I can make an exit like Alana did.
Well, let me tell you, you're going to have a lot of love out there today. Don't you doubt it.
Now, I will tell you this. On your way home, I would turn the radio off.
No music.
And let J-O-N get his call over with.
Yeah.
And then you can join us again because, you know, he's been waiting to see who did not get picked, and and he is going to call up and probably, you know, really have some fun with that. But we just want to tell you thanks for being such a good sport.
Because I had a blast.
This is, you know, it's a tough contest. It's not actually a barrel of fun. So, except for the dates. I like you had a good time.
Yeah, I did. I had a blast.
Thank you
very much. There she is, the lovely Candace. Hounds out there. There's one more that's free. You'll get a lot of email, a lot of calls. So thank you.
And I'm wore out.
I know.
Most
God bless you. Well, let's take a break. I think we all need to take a break.
Yes, I need a break.
All right, show this. Trista from The Bachelorette has arrived. And she's coming down
she's
the hall.
She's hiding now.
Yes. How did Tony get involved in this game?
I don't know. Tony is not one of the Bachelors. Yes. Let's be clear
and there,
on that.
There comes Trista.
She'll be here in just a minute.
And when we come back, we'll talk with her, and maybe she can give, you know, because she's been where Candace is right
she
now.
She has.
And so we'll discuss that when we come back as Trista joins us on the Rick and Bubba Show. 877-WE-BE-BIG. Our fax line is 205-945-3999. And on the World Wide Web, all this will be documented. It'll all be there on the website. Thank you, Ryan Greenwood and Timothy Witten. RickandBubba.com.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.
We're back. 14 minutes past the hour with the Rick and Bubba Show. Two sexiest fat men alive, and I tell you, we just experienced Trista from The Bachelorette is here, and she has lived what just happened here. Trista, welcome. Thank you for taking time to be with us today.
Of course.
I know a few people want to talk to you right now, and we feel flattered that you chose us. We think maybe your mom helped us out, but whatever it took. You know, if we have to call in a mom favor, we'll call one in.
Of course. Moms are good like that.
Are you getting tired of all this media stuff? I mean, your whole life is camera, camera, camera.
It is kind of crazy. I'm getting a little bit drained at times, but it's been so much fun.
It has to be.
It is.
Now, you were driving in, so you have not been updated. We've done our version of it called The Fat-chelor.
And that's
Casio Kid. Well, that's all right. I mean, you know, we've got a little weight on us. We don't hide that. And,
right.
And you know, it's big boy, big love. That's right.
Exactly.
Once you go big, you never go back.
Right. Yeah. And you seem to kind of like the somewhat big guy on The Bachelor, and he hung around.
Bob. Yes,
and
Bob was kind of our favorite. I have to tell
you,
the funny guy.
Wasn't
Bob
a lot of fun?
He is. He's the best. And we're still in touch. I know we'll stay in touch forever.
Well, so there it is.
Yeah.
It didn't work out with Charlie Orion, and now you're with Bob.
We made a friend connection.
No, oh, not the friend.
Oh, there it was.
Oh,
we did.
He's your friend.
How about we talked about that on the air. The worst thing you want to hear if you're kind of overweight, funny guy, is I want to be a friend. And everybody got on us, and then the guy that was hosting the show brought it up.
He did.
I go, well, there you go. See? Everybody knows
you just
that.
Don't know how scary it is for a guy who may be a little big to hear the word friend. Because, you know, what we get from women a lot is, you're so sweet. You're just like a big brother to me. Can we be friends?
Friend is code word for you ain't getting no sugar. That's what it means, okay? That's what it means.
It wasn't called the Fringerlet. It was The Bachelorette.
Yes, Fringerlet. You know what I mean?
So, but anyway, what I was going to say, you've been here. You know, we just had our version of it. The two ladies were here. Candace is here. She's going to have something here, too. She was not picked. The young lady who was picked is here. We want to introduce them both to you because you have been on both sides of this. You now have been the person who was there wanting to get picked. You're now the person who has to pick.
Any advice for Candace?
Yes. On picking, I thought she already
well,
picked.
Well, I mean, now that she did not get picked, like you did not, what now?
Go on with your life.
That's right.
Or sign a TV deal.
There are worse things
deal.
To not get picked.
Yeah, get a good agent and sign a TV deal.
And get a number from her from somebody at ABC.
Yeah.
So, Candace, thank you. You did very well. And you have a gift for Casio, even though he did not pick you.
I bought this for you.
Oh, my gosh. You feel terrible right now.
Wow.
Casio's
well, it
thinking.
Was for whether I won or lost, but, you know, it's
thank
for you.
You
anyway. You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
No problem.
Oh, my name. You've been there. You've been this person.
I have. But she's doing good.
Yeah, she is.
She's got a ton of fan mail. She'll have 100 dates tonight.
There she goes. There goes Candace. Y'all, let's give Candace.
Yay.
God bless you, Candace. God bless you. And bring Megan in. Megan is the young lady that was picked here on the Fatchler.
The two girls are hugging each other. Watch out.
Oh, look no, out. Watch out. A fight.
Well, wouldn't it be good TV, though?
Megan, meet Trista. Trista, this is Megan. This is a young lady.
And wow, there she is.
Congratulations, young lovers.
Thank you.
And are you excited now? How you feel?
I feel good. I'm excited.
Good.
Have y'all been like in the office making out or something?
No.
I mean,
no.
Huh? Cassio's got that look again, like he can't breathe. Have you noticed that?
How do you feel after this?
Like a winner.
Hey, is this Casio's day? I mean, is this the day come through of all time?
So hot today.
There he goes.
Hold on. There they are.
Oh my goodness.
There they are.
So this is also for you also.
You can't see her. It's such a big bag.
Yeah, Peggy's Hallmark.
Peggy's over there.
Hold it. We'll need hand trucks. We'll need hand trucks to get that out of here.
It's getting heavy for me, so take care of it.
Yeah, and you're also going to get a $500 gift certificate to Spa Moshus, and they'll be spoiling you rotten.
Oh, there you go.
And Casio will actually be doing the massage.
Yeah, that's them.
That's the surprise. Yeah.
Is that cool?
Well, we just want to tell you congratulations.
Well, thank you.
And you handled yourself very well. I know it was trying.
Damn, give this to
you. And there she is. So, and we'll have to show Trista some of the only hot tub scene that we had in the whole thing. It was one to remember.
Ooh, you had a hot tub scene.
Of course. You got to have that for ratings. You know, everybody knows that.
Hey, it's a show of me. But look. There was going to be a hot tub scene.
Yeah.
All right.
Cassio, when y'all carry that basket back, bring the cheese whiz back.
Okay.
Well, do you mind?
And the crackers.
Well, y'all go and spend some time together and be happy. We'll bring y'all back.
You crazy young lovers.
Congratulations.
Bye. Congratulations.
Nice meeting you.
Megan is not going to let go of Cassio at all.
Megan, don't let go. You worked hard for him, girl. Hang on.
Tell you what. You won't blow away in a March wind if you're holding on to him, you know?
Well, he can protect you. Let me ask you this, Trista. First question, what is tougher, being where these girls were or being where Casio Kid is, having to pick or to be the one wanting to be picked?
It's both. You know, I feel like this is kind of a cop-out answer, but it's easier and it's harder to make the decision. It's easier because I have the power, but it's
fun.
Also harder to, you know, say goodbye to guys that I've made connections with. So,
are you always shocked that those connections are made? Of course, you had been there, so you knew it could happen.
Yeah.
But, I mean, because to me, I think I get a feeling sometimes people go, I'm on a show, we'll see how this goes, it'll be a lot of fun. They almost look shocked when they find themselves actually falling for people. And that short
I did. I mean, I thought that there was a really good possibility, but you never know what's going to happen. I mean, who knows if these 25 guys are something that I'm looking for. I could have just found 25 friends and made it friendular.
Right.
Friendlerette.
Well, Bob did.
Yeah. But everybody loves Bob now.
You know, we all wanted you to get rid of Russ. That's what I hear. We didn't trust Russ.
He reminded us of somebody in advertising sales. That's what kind of,
oh,
you know what I mean?
That's
and,
what kicked it off for you guys. Sure.
But there was a guy who was in radio sales.
Josh Crone.
Yeah, and I was glad to see him go because you can't trust him.
No.
That's what everyone in radio says.
Well,
everyone in radio told
me that.
They're
heartless. They have no, they can't, they're heartless. Let me tell you something. Those salespeople are hitting the streets today and they're ready to cut somebody's legs out from under them.
Oh, I'm sorry, guys.
No, but that's
everybody out there in radio sales, I still love you.
No, they do their job, they do it well. Without them, we wouldn't get paid.
Right.
As a matter of fact,
we're the eye candy and they go get the money.
Yeah,
I mean, you know, it's pretty clear cut.
Do we really want
that good guy?
Yeah, do we really want them to have a conscience? Come on.
So, hey, we got to get paid around here.
Right.
Trista, this is one thing, though. It's we have talked about it since the very. Can we go back to the very first Bachelor?
Okay.
Yeah, Bachelor. I'm confused now. There's so many of them. On the very last part where, what's his name? I don't forget.
Alex.
Yeah, Alex, 007. Had to pick, okay?
Yes.
We were hoping, and I know that the standard thing is to get dressed up and put pearls on, have your hair up and all that. And that's a good look for you, okay?
No offense.
I'm good with that.
Okay.
But we felt like to absolutely secure the victory, if you had come out in your Miami Heat dance outfit.
Absolutely.
Oh, please.
And just had the music hit.
No, I mean,
you know, look. You know,
and this was his last look at you, and there's old Miss Priya sitting over there. Here you come.
Yeah.
Maybe.
He could not have put you in that limo with that going on.
What?
No way.
Thank God I didn't, because maybe he would have picked me.
That's true.
Have you been in touch with him? At all?
No, not really.
Are they still together?
Is he and that girl still together?
They actually just broke up.
There it is.
But it's been a year.
And Aaron and Helene are no longer?
Yeah.
Of course, we predicted that. He's going to get back with Brooke. Y'all write that down.
You know Brooke personally, so.
Yes, well, let me ask you this question.
I haven't met her yet.
Let me ask you this question. Mm-hmm. You've been there.
Mm-hmm.
You're there now.
Right.
Don't you get an awful lot of requests to appear at things, to come to stuff, to be on shows?
Tons, right?
Tons of requests around the country.
Yeah.
He picked Tuscaloosa. Said, yeah, I'll come.
To a women's show. Just happened to be in Tuscaloosa in 2 weeks.
Where Brooke goes to college. Well, isn't that interesting?
Oh.
Well, you know what? Honestly, if they're paying him some good money, I would go too.
Well, sure, but
I imagine he had them all
over
the country.
He had a lot of choices, and he just thought he'd pick Alabama.
Well,
of all the women's show, and nothing against the one in Tuscaloosa, but surely there were some in front of it.
Coincidence? I think not! Look, I know those two are in love. You can
tell. What time did you guys get up this morning?
We've been up about since about 4:30.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay,
We're high on caffeine and we're rolling, baby.
And we love it.
What are you here for?
We want you to love us more than Bob when you leave, but that's
all. Right.
That's on our request.
You're here in Birmingham, Alabama, where there's our flagship station where we do the show from, and you're in Birmingham this weekend, and what exactly are you going to be doing?
I'm going to be at Parisian River Chase Galleria tomorrow at 1:00. To do some meet and greets, just meet people, sign autographs, take pictures, that sort of thing.
Do the guys still hit on you? Do they go, hey,
you know, not really.
Because they figure you know.
But I'm taken, so it's all good.
So you are in love with the person you pick, and y'all are doing well.
Yeah.
Can you whisper it to me? I promise I will.
We all think you've picked Charlie. Because you were hot for him to begin with.
That's who my wife wants
you to be. And Ryan is driving us crazy because he's just too sensitive. You know what I mean?
He's not, though. Everyone's giving him the sensitive rap. Yes, he's sensitive, but Charlie's sensitive also. They just didn't show that side of Charlie.
Well, you know, when Bubba and I go out in public now, the show's really hit, people think we're Ryan and Charlie.
We get that all the time. Yeah.
Everywhere
we
go.
See that.
And I have to scream, no, it's Rick and Bubba. You're close, but you're not. But, you know,
But you both have wedding rings on your fingers.
Yes, we're happily married.
14 years.
7 years, beautiful.
13 going on 14.
Between us, we got piles of kids. We got 6 kids. And so if you want to know what it's going to be like from here on, we can tell you that.
Yeah, you can interview us on that one.
Unfortunately, you know, we have to watch TV now and live vicariously. We forgot what that part was like. But we're all very, very romantic. You saw my wife call and wish me happy about
it.
Betty couldn't get through. It was probably busy. But we, she's still waiting on that land deal to get done. But
sure,
I actually got in there, had a card in my car this morning. Very sweet for my wife.
In your car?
Card.
Well, I got so much junk in mine, I couldn't find it.
Well, it took me much to find it.
Speaking of that, how bad was the apartment? That is something we've got to email. Ask her how bad the apartment was.
It really honestly was not that bad. They made it seem so bad. I did not have a problem with it. Apartments in New York are really expensive.
Sure.
And I've lived in small apartments before. I did not
your
think
mom
it was going to be
about
huge.
That.
Yeah, I didn't think it was going to be huge. And he told me before we went in that there was a guy subletting that was a pig, pretty much.
Yeah.
And that it was probably going to be a little messy. So I was ready for it. They just made it seem with the music everything.
You got to do a show.
Yeah, exactly.
We told the two ladies a minute ago, I said, you know, they were talking about how uncomfortable some of this was, you know.
Uh-huh.
And I said, but you got to understand, there's two sides to this. Y'all are looking for love. But there's also people trying to put together a show that's going to be entertaining.
Exactly.
So those two things kind of clash a little bit. You know, we got a job to do to make it entertaining to the people listening and watching. And then you're in there trying to find what's real and not real. I can't imagine what that must be like. Forgetting cameras around and really trying to get to know somebody. How in the world?
Well, I mean, that was easy, actually. I forgot about the cameras, especially because I was on The Bachelor the first time.
Yeah, you were used to it.
And was used to the cameras. So that was no big deal for me. It's just hard watching scenes and how they edit it sometimes. I mean, I'm really good friends with the producers, so I understand they need to make a television show. It's just there sometimes when I just... Why can you have put this sentence in and taking that one out?
I know.
You know?
And can I just... You're going to be glad to hear this, I think. Maybe some people have already told you this. The cowboy. I mean, hey, let me just hold on a second. If I didn't like dogs,
right,
and there was, and I've got 25 women to choose from,
mm-hmm.
and one of them is saying I raise dogs and I've got dogs everywhere,
right,
in the house, in the car,
to me,
in the bed.
To me, it is not shallow to say, you know what, I don't have long to get to know all of y'all.
Amen.
I don't really want to be with somebody that's got a pile of dogs.
Exactly.
And I'd like to, because dogs are your, you know, it's not like horses or something he kind of does. He's all about horses.
It's his entire life.
How is
and
that?
And he said he's been doing it since he was like 5 years old.
How does he, I want to grab him and shake him and go, buddy, it's not shallow for her to make a decision that she doesn't like horses.
It's just a preference.
You've got horses
I'm
everywhere.
I'm allergic also.
Why would you want to date somebody that's going to have horses everywhere if that's not what you want to be around?
Exactly.
That makes sense to me.
And you know, Rick,
your whole point about how there's 25 guys, I had 24 other guys to choose from.
Right.
It was just that this was an easy way to say, okay,
there's
Brooke, I'm sorry, but, you know, you're just not the most compatible for me.
You know something? You shallow, and I told her right to her face she's shallow.
I know. And we actually cleared it up at the reunion show, so it's all good now.
But I wanted to rattle him and go, how can you think? How do you not understand what she's trying to tell you?
Plus, I don't trust anything that doesn't have a clutch.
That's true. Can you stay with us another segment?
Yeah.
All right, we'll be back. Trish is with us, 877-WE-BE-BIG. We got some more questions. She'll be at Parisian tomorrow, 1 o'clock, at the River Chase Galleria in Birmingham, actually in Hoover, right outside Birmingham. So if you're going to be in the area, you'd like to meet Trish, to make plans to be there to meet her tomorrow.
We really got one question that you answered that we want you to clear up for us if we can.
Okay.
Somehow write it down or whisper it to me or something.
We'll be right back. Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba. She makes a decision, Ryan or Charlie, and they go home to see Mama, don't they? And Daddy,
and Daddy
too. Daddy and Mama.
Stepmom and stepsister.
Oh, my gosh. So they got to deal with all parents, everybody involved.
Yep.
And your mom said the two men she met were very nice young men.
They are. They're great guys.
Want to let you know, too, since Trish is here, it's Birmingham, Alabama tomorrow, where you can meet her live at the River Chase Gallery at Parisian. She'll be at Parisian also in Atlanta on Sunday at 1. Those of you watching in Atlanta.
Is Rick saying Parisian right?
That was a big controversy.
We argue about it every time.
I used to say Parisian.
I say Parisian.
And then somebody said, no, it's Parisian. Which one is it?
I was cleared out. We've been well-trained. It is Parisian.
Did I say it right that
time? You mean I'm right?
I'm right.
Wow, that's a first. That's a first.
I started saying that you spell it, but I mean.
A lot of people try to put an S on it.
Parisians?
Yes, they do.
And Bill's an S adder. You've never done that.
I'll say Walmart's in a minute.
It's a deceptive word.
So in other words, so I switched to Bubba's way, and I was correct.
That's right.
Parisian, but I heard snickering when I said it.
You know, I used to work at Britches in Parisian. Right here.
Really?
Yeah.
Britches.
Yeah, the Britches department.
Trisha, can I just ask you a question?
What's Britches? Britches.
Yeah, Britches.
Do you find Speedy attractive?
Okay. He is very attractive.
All right. Yeah. When we get that.
He's happily married, but he's a magnet. I mean, he is a babe magnet.
It's the bald head.
That's right now.
It is.
We were afraid he was tainting our contest with the contestants because they're always hot for him. Debbie Gibson tried to pick him up in New York.
Debbie Gibson?
Yes.
Debbie Gibson. The singer?
Yes. Yeah. She was throwing herself at him.
Her mom, too, by the way.
Ooh.
Yeah. And I've caught your mom.
Terry's lucky.
He's hiding.
He's a lucky man.
Terry Wilburn is a lucky woman today. Right. Happy Valentine's to you, girlfriend.
Aw, you guys are so sweet.
Well, we've got a lot of questions.
Yeah, and, this is going to be delicate here.
Okay.
We need to. And look, we didn't want to bring this up, okay?
You're right.
But after the what do they call the flashback show of the night?
The one
it was just on.
Right.
After that question was asked you. Sorry, Mom, I can't look up.
Her mother is in the room.
No.
Her mother is in the room. Her mother is sitting here right now.
Well, I feel like it's my mom all of a sudden.
I know.
You was asked a question, and we won't repeat that question.
The studio audience question, the tall woman who had to bend down to the mic.
You gave her an answer.
I did.
It confused us a little.
My wife is an RN, okay? Mm-hmm. So I feel like, you know, well, she's an RN. And she turned around to me and said, what does she mean by that?
Mm-hmm.
And I said, oh, that means, and then I started thinking, what did she mean by that? And I thought, well, I'm just stupid, and I'm not going to say anything, because people will assume you know if you don't. But I came to work, and I had an idea in my mind, and I said, hey, Rick, what did Trista mean by what she said? And he gave me a totally different answer, and I said, uh-oh, that means nobody knows, okay?
Right.
And there's a lot of confusion.
I want to know what you guys said.
Well, I will give you a scenario.
Okay.
And you say, yes, that's correct.
Okay.
The way I looked at it is, since you're going to be at the mall and going to be in another mall tomorrow,
uh-huh.
We took at it like shopping. If you go shopping, there's a number of stores.
Right.
They're all a great shopping experience.
Rick, let's point this out. Everybody loves going to the mall.
Absolutely.
Right.
You know, to be at the mall is fine.
Sure.
Right.
But there's some malls that are set up, it's kind of an outside store.
Right.
It's easy to get to.
Exactly.
People shop there often. It's a great experience. You love it. But there's other stores maybe that are inside the mall.
Right.
Harder to get in there.
Exactly.
Harder to get there.
Back by the escalator.
But if you can work to get there, it's a great shopping experience.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yes.
And you said you have been to the easy shops that are easy to get to, but the other shops you have.
Exactly.
Is that it?
That's it.
You're right, Rick!
Oh.
Yeah!
Well, that's what I said. Yeah, that's... Well, yeah. You and I were saying the same thing. I was just talking about how you get to the mall.
Right.
Differently.
Yeah, well, we were talking about, do you just talk about the mall or do you actually go in the mall?
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you and I were saying the same thing.
Just in different ways.
Different ways.
Right.
Yes.
But we had some theories you would not believe. Emailed in.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm not even going to share those with you.
Some people said they're shopping by yourself and they're shopping with someone else.
No.
And that was not it.
No, it's all involved with another partner.
That's right. So we were right. We just had to have had some clarity.
And it is just one.
Yes.
You know.
It's one, but there's different. There's a lot of good sales.
About the two different ones.
Hey, there's a lot of good sales down at the mall. Okay.
Absolutely.
That is not even in the equation.
Right.
For me.
And but.
I know what you're saying.
Yeah.
I mean, you know. You're just saying. I know what you're saying.
Okay, good.
Our analogy was right.
That store at the back of the mall sometimes seems like it moves, though.
Right.
It, like, closes and moves over there, you know, near the teddy bear store.
And you might find that if you'll shop at the easy access stores, it's easier to get to the store that's further in.
No, I've shopped there a lot.
Really? Well,
how about that Fat-chelor?
Yeah. Huh? I'm going to give you my wife's phone number, and I'll let you talk with her.
Sure.
Okay? Because I don't think it's appropriate for me to give you any advice.
There's different malls. It just depends.
By the way, we're on the air.
Yes, I know.
We are broadcasting. There's some TV going here. I'm talking.
Gonna,
it's look, flying I'm out
I'm
to a bunch of stations.
I'm just going
to
put that piece of paper over there, and you draw a picture.
When we come back, we'll let you talk to Tristan. And there's no need to ask that question again.
Yeah,
I think
we got it covered.
But any other questions you have? At 877, we be big. Melissa in Nashville, Rodney in Hartsel, Cindy Albertville. We'll let you talk to Trista and others when we come back.
And remember, she's going to be down at the mall tomorrow.
Yeah, you can come.
I mean, you know what I mean.
Yeah, yeah. Right. And then again in Atlanta on Sunday. So, all right, we'll be back.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.
We're back. It is 15 minutes to the top. The Rick and Bubba Show, 877. We be big is our number. Trista from The Bachelorette is with us. She is on the phone right now talking to some other media across the country. She'll be back in here with us in a minute. We're getting calls wanting to know if she's coming to Atlanta. We just mentioned that to Chris and Marietta. She is coming to Atlanta on Sunday. Tomorrow's Birmingham. That's Saturday, 1 o'clock at Parisian. And then at the Galleria Mall. So we'll be at a mall. And then on Sunday at 1 p.m., it's Phipps Plaza Parisian. So she will be there on Sunday at 1 o'clock.
Phillips Plaza?
It says Phipps.
P-H-I-P-P-S.
It is Phipps. Phipps Plaza. So go by and see her tomorrow. I'm in Birmingham and then Sunday Atlanta. I'm a little uncomfortable now. My wife is on the phone.
Well, Rick, I just got a call from my wife, too.
Yeah, did you take that call?
Yes, I did, and she told me that I'd been shopping at the kiosk.
Right.
You just might want to go ahead to your call.
Well, I think she wanted to talk to Trista, who's not in here yet, but we'll be back. Hey, babe.
Hey, babe.
Happy Valentine's.
Happy Valentine's Day.
You feel like going shopping tonight?
What do you mean?
Well,
what's going on?
I just thought, you know, with Valentine's, maybe go out, try to do a little
something. Babe, guess what?
What?
Catherine is in.
We have a babysitter?
Yeah, a babysitter.
Oh! Yes! I can't even breathe.
I know.
So,
isn't that great?
That is great news.
The good news now, if you want to eat, you'll have to go at 3:30. But other than that,
well, you know, we've already just drunk. We didn't even try that.
Yeah.
We're going to go to the movie first and then go eat.
We're down at the mall.
Hey, we're giving out our idea.
Yeah, what we thought we would do is just forget trying to eat early. Just forget to eat a snack or something.
There's no way we're going to get in.
And then try to be a walk-up, like at 9 something. See if something's available.
But, yeah, we got to have this romantic. It's Valentine's Day.
I know. Thank you for my card this morning.
Yeah,
thank
you're
you very
welcome.
Much.
No, and I'm getting ready for my Brody's little baby class. He has a sweet little baby class on Fridays. And I was trying to get ready, but I saw Trista come in. Because, you know, last night you were saying that you didn't know for sure if she was even going to be there.
Well, you know, because she's sought after.
Scheduled to appear.
Yeah.
She was in the scheduled to appear mode. But we've had a mom card that nobody else had. Her mom listens to the show.
Yeah. Oh.
So she got her in
but,
here for
it. You know, I just wanted to tell her, and I hate that she's gone off and talking to somebody else.
Well, she'll she'll be back in just a minute.
We're speedy.
Yeah.
No, I'm kidding. Because, I just wanted to ask her, should I just wait on my question before...
Well,
Speedy
told me to kill time to get her back, that's what... You know, I really don't know how much longer she's going to be. I see people scurrying around out there. What do you want to ask her, babe? I mean, I'll still let you ask her, but I just want to be ready.
Well, I wanted to welcome her to Birmingham,
okay,
and I
that's
wanted
good.
To yeah. tell her I think she is one lucky lady.
Okay.
Not that I don't think I am, Rick. I think I am, like, the luckiest lady in the entire world.
Honestly, do you think I'm hot as Charlie R. Ryan?
Oh, definitely.
Are you looking at me right now on TV?
No, I'm not, because I was afraid of feedback.
Okay, yeah, that's true.
Does the TV do the feedback the same as the radio
does?
Even worse,
it's delayed, and like what you and I are saying, you won't even see it for a few seconds.
Oh, okay, see, so I'm in our bedroom right now.
Uh-huh.
Which, by the way, our bed is nice and fixed.
Mm-hmm.
Did you tell everybody about you breaking our bed?
Yes, I did.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, I did.
Yeah, well, so it's ready.
Took a little repairing, though, didn't it?
Yeah.
Had to bring in help from outside, a handyman.
Yep.
Oh, I'm sorry. Are we still on the air?
Yeah. We got it fixed.
Yes.
Right on our anniversary.
I think
that. Is that luck?
How about this? Seriously,
or you just leave it on the floor and you don't have to worry about it breaking again. Yeah.
Well, you know, you don't want people coming in and looking at the house wanting to buy it, and there's a bed.
But the kids can bounce on it.
Right, they get up on it.
Yeah, exactly.
Well,
when I was a kid, there was nothing better than bouncing on the bed like a trampoline.
I'm going to tell you, as an adult.
And, of course, I get on the mind for doing it, but I go, wow, it looks like fun. I wish I could still do it.
Let me say, as an adult, it's kind of fun to bounce
around. Sure. You don't hit your head.
Baby, I don't know. They're trying to get her back in here. What was the other question you're going to ask her?
Okay, I was going to ask her how she picked. Between the last two, from a female standpoint,
right.
And I know you two have no clue about guys. I mean, Rick
no.
doesn't know any, I mean, today,
and you know what? I'm glad of that, Sherry.
Huh?
I'm proud
Aren't
of that.
Aren't you glad, though?
Yeah, he doesn't know who's cute, and I'm not that I'm looking, or obviously, I'm a happily married woman, but I am a woman.
Right, and you
and
do
I
know.
And I can see, and, I mean,
she
both
thinks-
of these two...
Well,
the last two that she
right.
had to pick from were awesome.
She
even said herself that she was falling for both of them.
Do you know,
and
Mom?
She just had to choose.
You know what was her final that made her choose? Do you know? Mom doesn't know either. Because she haven't even told her who she chooses.
I think, you know, just
yeah,
going
well, see,
with the
I
past shows, they usually end up with whoever they were hot for right out of the gate.
You're right.
They always work your way back to them.
Do you remember that, Sherry,
yeah.
what she said when Charlie got out of the car?
Yeah, she was like, wow. I mean, I remember. Because, see, we didn't watch the first Bachelor.
Yeah, see, we came in late on it.
I never even saw her on that.
When that door swung open, I thought Peter Howell from Jacksonville stepped out for just a minute.
Did he look like
really?
The guy you
yeah.
went to school with?
Yeah,
oh, really?
He was Peter Howell's big brother.
But see,
yeah.
like, I can look at Charlie and Ryan and kind of understand, you know, the basics of, I
yeah.
guess that's a pretty good-looking guy,
right.
if I can say that. But, like, Sherry will tell me she thinks Sting is hot. And see, I'm like, Sting?
Sting is hot. I like the
Sting?
Kind of rugged, you know. Ryan, to me, is a little...
Go ahead and say it.
Well, as we said, and Rick came up with this word. I did not come up with this word. A little sappy.
Just a little sappy. We're just a little too sweet. You're giving me a cavity now.
Yeah, I can only stand about three poems a year. That's kind of the limit.
I personally am just a very aggressive woman, and I feel that Trisha
yes,
is the same way. I could not have ever picked Ryan just because of that. But I can see the initial attraction because,
right.
you know, initially, yeah, that's wonderful, but... It might get old.
All right, here
you know,
it is. Here's the question that every guy is thinking right now, and Bubba is too, and he's just being kind and not saying.
Yeah.
Can you tell me that if me and Ryan and Charlie were standing there?
Rick, why are you going there? Why do you even ask?
You would pick me over them?
Because I know you.
Right. But let's say that we just started dating, and I was one of the 25.
Rick, you don't want the answer to this question on Valentine's.
Where are you going with this?
Well, I'm just saying, do you think...
I mean, heck, it took me 1 year to even go out with you the first time.
Well, that's a good point.
Rick,
well,
you and I are holding on by a shoestring. Let's not push
You're right. What
okay.
you're saying is, Rick, you needed some time, and they don't give you time on that show.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah,
I
have to
I
grow
mean,
on
he
you.
He may have ended up, if she had more time,
mm-hmm.
picking somebody totally different. But, you know, I think on this show, she had to go with her impulse
You're
and
right.
her instinct, and her instinct probably was right, because I have agreed with her choices of letting people go, except I would have let Russ go a lot sooner.
Yeah, this right.
We were screaming, please
Russ,
get Russ out
Russ
of there.
Russ was slimy. I don't know how he made it so long.
He's got a future in used cars,
I mean,
no
we,
doubt.
We all,
I'm not trying to be mean.
No
either,
offense to used
I'm
car
sure.
salesman.
Yeah, but you know what I mean, Sherry? We all went to college with that guy over us. I mean,
yeah.
we all remember him.
And the guy peed on the bed. But it,
right.
Yeah.
Well, and what did you think? When Sherry was watching that, you know that's how men live when we're away from y'all.
Yeah, see, you know, the difference between The Bachelor and then The Bachelorette is just like, I think The Bachelorette was a little more, I don't know, I just...
Well, you can see how men group together is a lot different women.
Look,
group
we act a little more goofy, but we—I think our psycho numbers are way down.
Yeah,
I mean, really, overall.
Yeah, I agree. And
Russ
and
is
I
the closest
to
thing
say.
To psycho, and you can put up with him for a few rounds.
Men,
you know?
Men,
hey, Christy, she's out of there, baby.
Yeah, men are a lot more.
She's boiling rabbits. You know, come on.
You know, you never saw a Christy in the men thing. That's
a
good point.
Well, let's talk about Casio. Do you think he's made the right choice?
Do you mind commenting on that, honey? And I know you don't want to get caught up in that, but we're using you for a segment here.
I have to say that I didn't see all of the dates.
Okay.
So
you saw this morning.
I don't get up until, well, I get up at a certain time, and I have to rush and get Brooks ready for school, and he has to get off to school.
So you haven't seen many of the dates.
So it's usually about this time that I get to start looking at the TV.
Or even
listening it to the radio, you know, because we're just rushing to get everybody ready in the morning. So this is about, you know.
Well, what do you think? We're about to have to go to the break here in about 30. What was your feel today? You think you just made a good call based on the little bit of information you have?
I just think it was his choice. I really do.
Sherry, do you think you made the choice? Go ahead and say it.
Do you think I really should, Rick?
Yeah, Sherry. We want your perspective. We wanted it the other day. We couldn't find you in Betty. Y'all must have been shopping without
us. I am afraid. He did not make the right choice.
Did you say
there,
shopping?
There it is.
Yeah,
Sherry,
I like Candace's personality
Sherry
better,
Burgess.
And that's from a woman's perspective. I don't know what a guy likes. See, that's why you two.
Look, blondes everywhere screaming foul, Sherry. You should have stayed with the home team.
Yeah,
I mean,
you turned on another blonde.
Sure.
Well, it has nothing to do with hair color, or even. And I know everybody was saying Megan's look.
Yeah, but Sherry,
y'all were gonna be with us.
Turn
us out. I wish you were gonna be here.
We have another hour, and y'all are leaving.
I wish.
Love you, Sherry.
Love you too. Bye.
Bye.